Well, it's time for another Writing Wednesday. If you've watched my book reviews, you'll know that I don't consider good writing to be anything close to the hyperbolic prose of Hawthorne or even Dickens. For me, good writing isn't about attacking your reader with the biggest words possible or trying to get them lost in confusing syntax and never-ending sentences. Instead, I find that good writing is one thing. Completely unnoticeable. Now, before I explain further, I must impress upon you one fact that many people don't seem to understand. This is my opinion. An opinion. You know those things that everyone has and some are different? Feel free to disagree with me, of course, but try to retain your maturity if you do so choose. The point of prose is to put an image in someone's head. That's its only point. It's not there to impress you with how clever it is. Now, can it do that? Can I impress you with how beautifully it's formed? Of course! There are tons of times when I'm reading and I'm struck by an impressive sentence, or an entire passage. But it's impressive because it holds that beauty as well as perfectly conveying the imagery it's supposed to be conveying. Good prose flows through your mind. There shouldn't be any jarring or forced pauses that throw your conscience from the story. How many times have you been enjoying a book and then a sentence confused you, making you look up or perhaps just reread it? Maybe it was because of an unclear metaphor, or perhaps it was because it was part of a series of short, choppy sentences. Whatever it was, it made you look up or stop going forward. And that means you stopped with the story. When the writing is good, the prose becomes invisible, a medium you don't notice as it tells the story. And that's the way it should be. I pick up a book for the story, not for the writing. So how do you get better at writing? How do you prevent your reader from looking up? Well, there's no short answer to that. That's why I have this entire series. The easiest way is to just keep reading and keep writing. Eventually, you'll find what you like and what you don't like, and your style will form. The one biggest tip I can give is this: push yourself. But don't press yourself. What in the heck does that mean? Well, very simply this. Always try to make yourself better. Attack your weaknesses. If you feel like you're a bad dialogue writer, then write a huge conversation. Perhaps between a bunch of different characters, make it really complex. If you feel like your action is lacking, write a 10-page fight scene. But don't alter your prose consciously. Don't think that, oh, that word isn't big enough, and then turn to a thesaurus. Never turn to a thesaurus. Don't think that you don't use semicolons or em dashes or other crazy punctuation enough, and then force them into your sentences. Just write like you always would, and when you read over it, polish it to make it run smoother. If something grates at you when you reread it, then rewrite it. It's not easy getting better, but it is fun. The biggest thing is don't try to force yourself to get better. Just practice, and eventually you will. Now, as a lot of you have probably noticed by now, I haven't released a short story in a few weeks. I had a little challenge going with myself to try and write one every week for 50 weeks. That kind of stopped because a novel fell into my head and I am writing on it right now, and it's really, really good. But if you've missed my short stories, because I hope most of you enjoyed them, I have good news. I have compiled those short stories into a collection called A Midnight Stroll. It's back there. Now, right now, the collection is just an ebook, which will save people money on buying all the short stories separately if you've missed them when they came out for free. But I am considering turning it into a paperback. If y'all would be interested in that and having a paperback collection, I will do that. I'll put them into a paperback and then I will try to make it as cheap as possible and then sell them directly to the YouTube people through a link on my website where I will send out autographed copies of them cheaper than you would probably be able to buy retail versions of them. If that's something that's interesting to you and you would like that possibility or opportunity, let me know. And I guess that's that. I am sorry that it has been a while since my Writing Wednesday video, but I am back, and I'll check all of you out next week. Until then, keep writing.